All right, guys, I'm in trouble. I don't know what it is, but like I just have a tendency to attract crazy people, and I don't get it because I literally don't talk. And so I wonder, for the introverts out there, do you have that problem too? Here I was, minding my business, living a happy, peaceful life. And guess what happens? I get a new neighbor. And I don't really care if they see this, because this person needs to be called out if they continue this type of behavior. But let me tell you exactly why this person has to be crazy. It's the only thing that makes sense to me. So I hear someone moving next door, and I knew the apartment next door was vacant. And so I knew it was only a matter of time before someone moved in. So, you know, I hear their noises. I hear somebody's moving in. And so at the time I had to go run an errand, okay, me and my wife. And so we step outside, and you know, you could kind of see out of the corner of your eye. And so we're walking, and so out of the corner of my eye, I see this guy who is inside the apartment. The door is closed, but you can kind of see, because the blinds are like wide open, you can kind of see the person is moving their stuff inside, you know, with boxes and stuff like that. And so, you know, we passed the door, and 5-10 seconds later, the guy somehow left his apartment and is right behind us. I mean, he rushed to get out of his apartment and greet us. And so, you know, I thought that was a little odd, but I can understand, you know, someone wanting to meet their neighbor, you know, for the first time. So the guy was very talkative, but again, you know, I'm used to meeting talkative people. That happened. The guy talked for at least a whole 2 minutes, you know, but we had to go somewhere, so it was easy for us to kind of get out of that conversation. Boom, move on my life. A few days later, right, same exact thing happens, okay, except this time I'm by myself. I walk out because I have to go somewhere. Shortly after, this person comes out and just tries to start up a conversation with me. And at this point, I'm like, okay, come on now. This is 2 times where you have left the apartment exactly when I am leaving. And so that's very odd. Are you watching me? So already I'm like, oh man, this is going to be weird, man. This is really starting to mess up my peace, you know, because the guy can just talk. And he told me a little bit about his background. A lot of it doesn't add up, but again, I don't really care. I'm just trying to move on with my life. You know? Okay, fine. So at that point, I'm just like, I am just going to be very minimal in my conversation, which I always am, but I'm going to like really like kind of look tuned out, so that way he kind of like knows like I'm not really a talker like that. My goal, like going forward, I said I'm just gonna look like I'm in a rush, you know, that I don't have the time to talk. Usually I am in a rush to do something, so I don't really have time to like sit there and chat. Now this is the one that got me. This was yesterday. Okay, I get home, my car, and I'm walking towards my apartment, and this guy, he is still unloading boxes, you know, from his car. So mind you, it's been like over a week and it's still moving stuff, which is fine, whatever, but he's talking on the phone. So I'm like, okay, we good. I'm gonna just go right into my apartment and, you know, do my thing. And guys, I tried to walk by briskly, you know, I did the friendly head nod, you know, just to greet somebody. And again, I walked past the guy. I'm halfway to my apartment, and he literally puts the phone down and he starts up a conversation with me again about nothing, just small talk stuff. Now I was a little confused because I'm like, weren't you on a phone call? He talked for a good 30-40 seconds about nothing. Again, I'm looking like I gotta go. And then he says, it's a good thing I'm talking to my mom on the phone, otherwise I'd talk your ear off. And he laughs, and again, I'm just trying to be a cordial, you know, and I crack a smile, you know, and I'm like, no, you will not talk my ear off, because I would not stay there for you to talk my ear off. I'm trying to get to my apartment. I got things to do. And so now you have officially shown yourself to be crazy. I don't want anything to do with that. I'm good. My life is peaceful. I've reached a good place. Okay. So I'm just wondering if anyone out there has crazy neighbors, because I just was not expecting this. Again, like, I'm going to mind my business and probably going to have very minimal, you know, interactions with this individual. But there's going to be times where you're entering our place at the same time. So I'm just trying to figure out how to deal with this situation, because this is not someone that I'm looking to get to know more. It's not someone that I would want to get to know more. I can see if it was somebody normal, but this is somebody with red flags all over it. And I just want to avoid this person at all costs. So yeah, this is where we're at. My wife too, we like sometimes attract crazy people. And I wonder if this is something that introverts often deal with. And I think maybe because we tend to be good listeners. So when someone sees that, they use that as an opportunity like to try to talk a lot. When they think that we're not judging them, but really, you know, inside of our head, we're having all kind of like judgmental thoughts, you know. So I think that's what it might be. You know, I could be wrong, but let me know what you think in the comments and some advice on how to deal with this situation, because I don't got time for this.